What's up, everybody? This is Joshua. I'm doing like A plus certification practice thing where, yeah, tells you pretty much all you need to know. Well, I'm hoping, because this is my first time doing this. I did do one little thing, modular in mobile devices, just to see what it was like, and it was all right. It was all right. I mean, I had some difficulties, but I will go ahead and do it again. See, like, all right. So I'll tell you what there. This is like a legit certification place where you can get like more than one thing. Let's see. No, I didn't save it, but it wasn't cheap. But let's go ahead and start in mobile devices, and I'm gonna start in Oh, given the scenarios, I guess 1.1 today. Even though I just did it, but we'll just do it again. Let's see, refresh. Pretty sure if I do this, that means I'll do it again, right? No? Let's try this. Oh, this is just showing the things I got wrong. Got a couple of them wrong, but yeah. Wait, why can't I redo it? Oh, here we go. All right, so it says, what is the best option when replacing plastic or aluminum frames of a laptop? Like the best option. It says upgrade the plastic, or it says obtain manufacturer services, or disassemble the chassis. It says if it is on warranty, send it to the manufacturer. See, I didn't know. When I took this test, that's what it was. I thought it was like, look for some documents before replace it. Like, hey, see what's wrong with it, kind of thing. So that is the best option when replacing, if it's under warranty. Like, I'm 100% sure that is the answer. It says, after troubleshooting power problems, you notice the DC socket on your laptop is damaged. What is a good skill you should learn if you want to replace a DC jack in your laptop. I think I already knew this, but I put unsure the first time. 'Cause yeah, like most of those is soldering. Now this is just how this kind of test is. It's I like it. I mean, other people might like to actually read this stuff and figure it out, but it's like I'm kind of learning like stuff I didn't know I learned. So after users bring your new mobile device whose non-removable battery is very short, the user does not use location services or spend any exceptional time watching videos or playing video games. What do you advise the user to prolong the device's life? So they're like asking, how can this help to make his stuff longer? And see, the thing is, you have to make sure you read that, because if you don't, you have to make sure you read these questions carefully. I'm pretty sure that's probably what's gonna be on a test. I haven't took the test yet, but that's probably stuff. So like, you have to make sure you read stuff like that. So when you look at the answers, it's like turn off Bluetooth and cellular devices and use Wi-Fi instead. Says, or purchase a new battery. Well, that kind of defeats the purpose of what the questioner asking. That's why you look and like, oh yeah, because that would be the better solution in my eyes, but it depends how much life is left in that battery. And see, it says keep the device plugged into the power at all times. I mean, you could do that, but that seems very like you're always stuck to somewhere, and that's like defeats the purpose of a mobile device in my eyes, but I don't, yeah. So So this is what I thought the answer was power off the device when it is not in use. And the reason why I thought that is like, okay, I'm done using it, let me turn it off. But I guess I didn't read the question. It says, you know, location services and that other stuff. So it's like, well, if he doesn't use any of that stuff, really, you can just, this I guess would be the answer. But to be honest, you could do that and power off the device. But I guess if he has a phone call, it'll be missed. But I think, yeah, use Wi-Fi instead, yeah. It says, no matter how long you leave, in a good, basically says, you know it's a good power outlet. When you unplug the laptop, it dies. When troubleshooting, you clean the battery contacts and make sure it's properly seated. When you replace the battery with a good battery, you know it's good. With the same model, it works fine. What can you determine is most likely the cause of the problem? Says the power LED needs replaced. What? Yeah, that's no. Says the battery has ended its useful life. The battery is most likely completely discharged. An app is putting excessive strain on the battery. Well, the answer is the battery is dead, which they word it is. The battery has ended its useful life. What I thought it was this one right here. The battery is most likely completely just discharged. I mean, like, I was like, oh, okay, yeah, that makes sense. The battery's dead, you know, discharged, but no, I was wrong. It's like, it's literally the battery's dead, but in a different wording. Do you want to upgrade an old video card in a laptop in a high-end? Says your goal is to turn into a gaming machine to replace your desktop. What is the problem you might face when you trying to accomplish this? Well, I didn't know you could do that in some laptops, but I guess like very few laptops you can. All the laptops I repair, they're soldered on. I know you can upgrade CPUs, so I was like, it had to be because the laptop may run. I was like, that didn't make any sense. So you get audio. I was like, nah. It's like Wi-Fi. It's like the only thing it had to have been. It was like it's overheating. But yeah, that makes sense. If there is laptops that you could do that, you would have to worry probably about that, and probably might have to get a different kind of like heat sink and another way to get rid of the heat. But yeah, say for maximum performance, what is the DDR? See the sticks one upgrading the laptop. Says for maximum performance, what type of double data rate, which is DDR synchronization of DRAM or /SRAM or /SRAM memory module should be used when upgrading RAM in the laptop? Well, I know it's not DIMM because that's for desktop usually, so you cross that out, and it's like for maximum performance you want the 4, but it doesn't say for what type either, so. It is. No, it's not that answer. It's this. Cause that's for laptops usually, because it's that small stick. You can use these on desktops, but you need like a weird slot thing that goes into those things that go into the desktop. I forgot what the expansion or. I don't know what they're called. But I've seen them done. Not really worth it, I don't think. But that's so yeah, maximum performance. But what if it doesn't fit? So which of these does not need to to be connected to the system board when replacing them. See, I was confused at first when I saw this system board. Oh, the motherboard. Well, the same thing. I was a little confused because I never really heard it called a system board like that. But it's like, is it the AC adapter, laptop speaker? It's like laptop speakers you have to take out. Introvert also, and the smart card. So the only thing that you don't have to take out would be the AC adapter. That doesn't have to be connected. It says your laptop screen appears to be broken and does not display any pictures, even though there is no visible cracks or breaks on the screen. What is the first step you do before replacing? Okay, so when I get laptops from customers, I usually, like, the first thing is I have like an external, I got a little small monitor like on my workstation, and I check like if it's broken. It's like, is the computer still running? Is it working? Some laptops don't show up. It's just not some, yeah, some laptops won't tell, so doesn't necessarily mean it doesn't work. It's just another, some laptops, a lot of laptops actually, if you plug it in, if it works, it, you'll find out it works right off the bat. Yeah, right here. So it's like, connect your laptop to an external display to verify that the problem resides in the screen and not another component. So I'm gonna keep going. It says you need to connect to the guest wireless network in your corporate environment. So what could you install in a laptop that did not have a wireless compatibility? So you can basically, it's asking, do I have Wi-Fi on my laptop or something? Like, nah, man. So what am I gonna do? Personally, like, they do have little, like, USB Wi-Fi things, but I guess you could do like the PCIe, a Wi-Fi adapter and a PCIe. That wouldn't work because it has to be a mini, and it's not a SATA. Whoops. But so yeah, like Bluetooth, I don't think would be the answer. So when replacing a 1.8 hard drive disk in your new laptop, what type of connector would you most likely need to use? So you obviously know it's not, because that's big, and it's not a Molex. So it has to be a USATA. What is a cellular card used for? It's definitely not that, the Bluetooth connectivity, and it's definitely not just it's not Wi-Fi. You connect to any wireless network now, and it's like, so that's the only one. Is that an end user has complained about slow transfer speeds on a laptop and wouldn't mind like sacrificing storage space for better. So he's asking for really fast performance. In fact, the user wants to be able to transfer, yeah, from like, yeah. So what would you, so hey, I want my stuff to be transferred super fast. What would you suggest? It's like, definitely not another hard drive. Like, that doesn't make any sense. And it's like, not a, like, a RAM. Like, that also doesn't, or random access memory. That also doesn't make sense. Or, like, the hybrid disk. So the best answer would be solid state. Like, you want performance. You said you don't care about how much storage you have. Which of these would you typically want to replace with the original OEM part on the laptop? Like, typically, like, you can use any RAM, any disk, any CPU. No, it's fine. Central processing unit. Yes, has to be most likely a smart card reader. When upgrading the touchpad on the laptop, I might say I don't remember all these, but I'm just like I kind of remember if that makes sense. Like, I'm almost like I'm retaking this thing again. I only did this. This is my second time. When upgrading the touchpad on a laptop, what may you need to do to make it function properly? So when you, yeah, I've done this before, which I didn't figure out until a little bit, like about a little research on the internet, installing drivers, like, yeah, that's like one of the things you want to do. Installing a new OS, yeah, it's not gonna work. And network setting has nothing to do with it. See, the configure the touchscreen settings, that's what I was having problems because I thought that that's what was the case. But it's like you just had to install new drivers. A touchpad. I thought it was talking about touchscreen. Oh, yeah. Well, yeah. I mean, I guess that's probably the same concept. You are replacing a non-function cracked touchscreen display on a laptop. However, after completely removing the touchscreen, you forgot the existing unit was connected to the graph. Like, basically, how you forgot how to put it back together. So I ask a service desk. I mean, you're supposed to be the person that knows what you're doing. You could write down the model number and then look it up on like Google or YouTube. But like they're saying, and mental note, that's the reason why you forgot it in the first place. I was like, take a picture. After troubleshooting, you have determined you need to replace the system board in your laptop. And you feel this is a good opportunity to upgrade the CPU. Given the situation, which of the following would you need to do? Install whatever CPU to the motherboard? That's what I thought it was. That was kind of dumb. Say detach the standoff, update the drivers. Say, I guess take it apart first. When upgrading the keyboard in a laptop, what do you need to make sure the keyboard functions properly? Say, remove the ribbon. Say, no. Reinstall the old drivers. Install new drivers. Install a new keyboard with the same OEM. Like, install new drivers, man. You are a help desk technician, right? Responding to a ticket that states the user's laptop optical drive is no longer working. The user indicates that the drive is only used to exchange large files with another person who has poor network service. Which of these would be the most cost efficient and basically what would be yeah how much what so it's like an ex offer their offer the user an external optical drive. So it's basically saying, do you want the optical drive on the outside? Says, and then that one is asking, do you want an external hard drive? Says, or replace that spot for a hard drive. And then it says, order an internal, like basically the replacement. It's like, that makes more sense is the hard drive. Like, because I. He doesn't have to buy anything, but to me, honestly, it's just, hey, just get a flash drive. When upgrading the system board with a ball grid array, which of these steps would not be required to perform? So would not be required to perform. So you would have to update. And you would have to do that. I'm pretty sure you'd have to detach the standoff. I don't think you'd have to remove it. It's like, and you guys can like choose multiple answers or two different answers. If like, oh man, I don't know if it's you would need to install an M.2 or if you need to install a graphic adapter, and then it'll. Like, oh, you got those wrong, or if one's right, you'd be like, oh, so that was the right answer, so. But you weren't basically sure. But this is my second attempt. I want to see if I can remember everything. It looks like I have so far. I have two more questions to go. It says an end user has purchased a new Bluetooth speaker, but the end user's older laptop does not have Bluetooth adapter. What would you need to install to connect music playing from the laptop to the Bluetooth speaker? So it would be an M.2 slot that goes into the laptops, but to be honest, I think it would be like those little Bluetooth USB things. Like that would be way cheaper than like paying somebody to install one of these into a laptop. But you know, that's a matter of like, hey, I want an extra USB slot, or I'm trying to save money, or you know, like I'm trying to save money, or so I don't care about money, just I want it to look sleek kind of thing. Oh yeah, man, look at that. That looks awesome. That's what I'm talking about. I did very good this time. Heck yeah, man, I got them all right. That is what I'm talking about. So this was 1.1. It says installing and configure laptop hardware and components. That's what I'm talking about. So look at that. Yeah, man. Even says how long have I worked on it? Total hours spent about 1 hour and 30 minutes. Oh, and it says I took a refresh one extra one, so that's what I'm talking about. Well, that's the end of that course, and I'll see you next time on 1.2, given a scenario, install components within the display of a laptop. Thanks. Bye.